Well, from tomorrow, more Melburnians will be able to meet up outdoors and get back to a selection of the activities they love. The new freedoms have also breathed life back into the fitness industry, but only for some, as Laura Turner explains.
Finally, Melbourne is winning round two of the bout against coronavirus. And for personal trainers, today's easing of restrictions is a weight off their shoulders.
Absolutely. Obviously, it just starts getting you out a little bit of financial hardship in the beginning, but just seeing those people again, I can't wait to see half of my clients again.
Exercise, including hiking, fishing, boot camps and swimming at an outdoor pool, will be permitted within 5 kilometres of home. A two-hour limit will still apply. The freeze on gyms remains, some PTs angry with the Premier.
I'm annoyed. I'm angry. I'm on JobKeeper from Good Life, but I hate it. I want to go back to work.
Melbourne's canine community relieved. Retail groomers will reopen.
She desperately needs a good groom, you can tell.
However, tennis, bowls and golf clubs will remain closed for now, along with skate parks and indoor play centres. Max Charles should be in the US on a golf university scholarship. Instead, he's home, lamenting what he calls inconsistency.
Even though you're allowed 5 people outdoor doing social stuff, but you're not allowed 2 people walking in an open area on a golf course.
The Premier hinting Max might not be waiting too much longer.
It is my view and my hope that we will be able to make a change to that in about 3 weeks' time and then not have to further restrict that activity ever again.
Melburnians can now meet in groups of 5 from 2 different households, hugely significant for families.
Socialising with friends and neighbours, and kids can socialise as well. The older one, she really missed the company.
It's not natural for kids not to be able to see their friends for so long.
The Premier has reiterated these social gatherings cannot be inside private homes or even backyards. They're restricted to public spaces only.
The state opposition says today's announcements are nowhere near enough.
The lack of common sense in the announcements.
Those who feel left behind, brides who can only have 5 people at a wedding.
I just would like some more clarity, so to not forget about us, and we'd really like to know when and where we're allowed to get married.
Victoria's restrictions easing in baby steps. Laura Turner, 9 News.
Well, families across the city are elated with the announcement all primary students will return to face-to-face learning in 2 weeks. And while there's no timeline yet for years 7 to 10, the Premier is hopeful schools will be full by the end of the year. Lana Murphy has the story.
Kids have spent most of this year glued to a screen, but today this dad was happy to let it go.
Oh, yeah. We're back. Yes.
Hearing the news every student and parent was waiting for.
We will be able to have all of our primary school kids back at school in the week beginning the 12th of October.
We're wrapped. She's done well, but yeah, it'd be good for her to go back and see her friends.
Like 1 million others, 12-year-old Zara Johnson has learned this year's curriculum from the kitchen bench.
It's a lot of time in front of the screen as well.
Yeah, like half the class came back with glasses. We don't get to, like, meet people. There's only, like, your family there. And then you get sick of them after a while.
But in 2 weeks, the grade sixer will be back in the schoolyard. Face-to-face learning returning for all primary students from October 12. It's the same for those studying VCE and VCAL and every year level at specialist schools.
It's been a great test of resilience as well. And no one's been more resilient than the students and the parents.
It's up to individual schools to stagger the start days and times, and it's likely every student will have their temperature checked before entering school grounds. In Victoria, 373 students and 139 staff members have been infected with COVID-19, but multiple studies have shown
primary school children are at a lower risk of getting and spreading infection. And this isn't to say that they can't get infected or they never get unwell, but their risk is lower.
But the data isn't so clear for senior students, which is why there's not even a tentative date for the return of years 7 to 10. The government wants them back before the end of term 4, but says it's relying on public health advice to determine that. That's why most university students will also need to continue learning from home. The only exception, those in their final year of studies, who need to be on campus for assessments and work placement. Speaking of work, many parents can now get back to it in peace, with childcare open to everyone from tomorrow.
It's been a handful having the little people at home.
Now the challenge lies in getting the little people to leave.
And what about school?
Not very excited about that because I like homeschooling better.
Lana Murphy, Nine News.
Well, with the curfew lifting tomorrow, supermarkets are once again adjusting their trading hours. Stephanie Anderson joins us now live from Moonee Ponds. Steph, they'll resume their standard timetable.
Yeah, they will, Alicia. It means from tomorrow that both Coles and Woolworths will keep the doors open until 10 p.m. And the restriction around only one person per household going shopping once a day has also officially been lifted, with the Premier encouraging Melburnians to use that very small slice of freedom within reason. It comes as businesses across a range of sectors reacted to today's announcement, some welcoming a small step towards what's now known as COVID normal. Others are calling on the government to give them the same go.
For John Wilds, the grass is greener on the other side of 8 weeks off work.
Oh, it's fantastic. You know, I've had plenty of positive responses from my customers.
He's one of hundreds of sole traders in garden maintenance and landscaping given the OK to get back to business tomorrow.
We've had 60, 70 emails and texts. Everyone's so happy we're coming back. It's fantastic. I can go back to work now.
An opening too for the real estate sector, with one-on-one inspections resuming. It follows a strong push from agents who've had to try to sell stock without a buyer seeing it.
Obviously, it'll be a controlled environment. Social distancing will still occur. Face masks still will be used.
In construction, idle cranes will be restarted as the percentage of the workforce allowed on site increases from 25 to 85 tomorrow morning, but only for large-scale projects.
85% will pretty much get the balance teams, whether they be plumbers, electricians, carpet layers, painters, concreters, back on site. So we'll be able to get back to pretty much normal.
On smaller sites, a maximum of 5 workers remains, while specialist contractors can visit up to 5 projects a week, but no more than 2 a day. Other industries also watched closely, but the best hair salons can hope for is an opening on October 19, a week earlier than before.
A week's better than nothing. It's going to take a long time to get through all the appointments missed and book all the appointments for the rest of the year.
There was no restriction sweetener for those running cafes, restaurants and pubs, despite their pleas for more options.
Hospitality is on its knees. We can't keep going on like this every month.
They say, like the other sectors, starting to find some sense of normality, they too have COVID plans and are ready to operate within the limits.
We believe we can open safely.
Stephanie Anderson, Nine News.
Well, the Prime Minister has weighed in on today's announcements, comparing Victoria's response to New South Wales. Political editor Chris Yuleman joins us now. Chris, what did he have to say?
Yes, Lisa, the PM, Treasurer and Health Minister have released a joint statement that takes another swipe at Premier Daniel Andrews. They welcome the removal of the curfew as a small but important step, before noting that at similar case levels, New South Wales was fundamentally open while remaining COVID safe due to world-class contact tracing. They urge Victoria to review the timetable for reopening because, as it stands, Melbourne's lockdown is already longer than that faced by residents in many cities around the world. And the trio say they are deeply concerned about the mental health effects on Melbourne residents. Alicia, as are we all.
Yes, indeed. We'll see the Premier's response, no doubt, tomorrow. Chris Yuleman there, thank you.